This is a modified D-28, and if I remember correctly, this is an 80's model, 474. It's a D-28P, and that means it has a low-profile neck. Martin called them a P for a while before the low-profile neck just kind of became the standard neck. I had this guitar several years ago for some work. Did scallop the braces, did a bridge plate, and did a neck reset, fret job, tuners, popsicle brace, you know, the works too. And I saw it back in January. I know the owner personally. And I saw it back in January, and the action had really come up a lot. And it really needed another neck reset. So I took it home and redid the neck again. And I'm not sure exactly why it needed a reset. I can tell you that the top is really bulging in right here. So it's got a real dip right here. Everything checks out, you know, all the braces are tight, there's no crack braces, there's nothing wacky going on. It doesn't even really have a very big belly back here, you know, so it's not like it's about to blow up or anything. I didn't over scallop it. In fact, the top looks real nice. It just is falling in right here, and you can see it, and it's well past the popsicle brace area. If you lay a straight edge across it right here, it's bowing in right here. And that's just the way it is, you know. Maybe the wood's soft. Maybe the sides are soft. Don't know. I studied it for a long time. I kept it for about a month before I did anything to it and humidified it and everything and unstrung it to see if the humidity would make it pop back up. And nothing changed. So I just reset the neck again, and it didn't take much, you know, just 15 thousandths of an inch off the heel or so, just a little bit, in order to get the action back down again. The action was pretty high when it came in. It was like a 105 or 110 or something like that. It was just a little too high to be comfortable, and the saddle was just a little too low, so it just needed a little bit of adjustment. Since I like to back up my guitars, I offered to reset it, so I did. And while I was at it, I found a bunch of loose bracing, and binding. A bunch of the binding was loose, so I glued that back up. I think I found a loose back brace or two, glued that up, high fret up here, fixed that. This fretboard's a little bit wonky, and I remember having trouble doing the refret on it because it had a lot of dips and curls in it, and it's kind of thin already, you know. It looks to me like it's been sanded down at one time, and I can see up on the fingerboard that there were divots that were filled. I'm not sure if these are going to show up on the camera or not, but up on the fingerboard, you can see different colors, and that's where it had divots in the fingerboards, and somebody filled it with super glue, that kind of thing. But in any case, the fingerboard was a little bit wonky, and I remember having some trouble getting a good clean refret job on it. So it doesn't surprise me that there was two frets high, you know. Things pop up and they change a little bit over time. I took care of that anyways. So, there it is. A banjo player owns this, so I played a banjo tune on it to begin with. Here's my standard set of guitar test stuff. So what this is basically an example of a guitar that I scalloped and hot rodded several years ago. And I don't remember how many years ago. I'd have to look and see. And this is what it sounds like with a little bit of age on it. I didn't do an aggressive scalloping on this guitar. Just wanted to open it up a little bit. It was pretty nasally bass, and so I just wanted to sound a little bit more richer and play good mostly. Now it plays real nice. So the action is 3/32 of an inch or 93/1000ths, 9/80. Fingerboard is flat. Nut is at fret height, so everything's where I would want it to be. Plays good now. Here's my standard look stuff for comparison purposes. I already played rhythm, but here we go again. D-28.